Hello, YouTube. This is Doris, and this is your Monday Night Raw recap. I did record it earlier in the week, but I must have included too much WWE video because YouTube blocked it. Redoing the video with less video content and more of me. So you get to see more of me. All right. So a little bit of a recap. We kicked off the show with Drew McIntyre talking about winning the Rumble. He did announce that he was going to challenge Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania for his title. And he talked a little bit about the Rumble and how he knew he would win. He said that he had a lot of energy that he wanted to burn off and wanted to know anybody in the back who had the balls to come out and challenge him. The OCs, Carl and Luke Gallows, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows came out and both challenged to accept his open challenge. So we had a handicap match, which Drew McIntyre won. He gave both men a Claymore kick and put them on top of each other for the pin. And then as he was throwing them out of the ring after the match, Brock Lesnar came down and attacked him, leaving him on the floor after an F5, or on the ring floor with an F5. We did see another squash match with Eric Rowan. I'm kind of starting to get sick of the squash matches, but I suppose until they either get rid of this whole storyline or move on with it, we have to grin and bear it. We saw MVP in action against Rey Mysterio, so apparently he is staying on with WWE. Not sure yet the details of his contract. I've not had a chance to look that up. We saw Liv Morgan beat Lana in a very fast match. Some of the rumors with her storyline is they are going with a split personality scenario. They've kind of given some hints to it, like the split screen on the Titantron, the black and white. She's on one side of Rusev smiling and jumping around. Then she moves to his right side and she's very stern and scary looking. So there is a possibility that they are still going to go with the Sister Abigail storyline, just kind of like almost like a Bray Wyatt scenario where he's the Fiend in some circumstances, other circumstances he's happy Bray Wyatt. We saw Charlotte Flair versus Asuka, which ended up being a disqualification because Kairi Sane did get involved and did break up a submission by Flair. We saw Aleister Black in a squash match, and he announced that he's done waiting for people to knock on his door and challenge him to a fight, that he is going to start bringing the fight to the locker room. So hopefully we'll see a little more of him in action. We saw the Viking Raiders ended up. So we saw Samoa Joe and Kevin Owens versus Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy for the tag team titles. At the beginning of that match, Kevin Owens and Samoa Joe were saying how they knew that the AOP would come out and attack them and they would be a 4-on-2 advantage. Seth showed the AOP in his private dressing room and Kevin Owens thanked him and said now they don't have to look for them anymore. And Seth and Buddy got to watch the Viking Raiders attack AOP to keep them out of the match. But during that match, Samoa Joe did get hurt. He jumped out of the ring to push Buddy Murphy against the barrier and ended up hitting his head So the medical team made Samoa Joe leave the match, which made it a 2-on-1 handicap match with Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy against Kevin Owens. They did end up winning that. Kevin did try. He did put in a good effort and did get a couple of pin attempts, but all of them being broken up. We also saw Carrillo versus Andrade for the U.S. title. So apparently Andrade violated the wellness policy, so he has been suspended to explain him not being on TV for the next month. They had Carrillo do the hammerlock DDT on the floor, moving the mats to portray an injury to Andrade. And then we saw Edge in the ring at the end of the night, and he talked about his return. Randy Orton did come out and talked about what if Rated RKO got back together. He did end up attacking Edge. He gave him the RKO and then the Concerto. He originally put Edge's head inside the folds of the chair and made it look like he was going to jump on it. A little bit of that footage will be in this video. But that was pretty much the end of Raw. It was a decent show this week. I'm happy that MVP and Edge are staying on. I do know the contract details of Edge, or at least some of them. Apparently it's a 3-year contract. He will be expected to wrestle 5 times a year with a minimum mandatory of 3 times a year. So more than likely it's kind of like a Brock Lesnar type of contract where we will probably only see him competing at pay-per-views maybe once or twice, other than that on weekly shows. But other than that, that was pretty much it. Like I said, there is going to be a little bit of footage, but I'm not going to do too much. All right, peeps, let me know if you like this video. I appreciate your support, and hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't yet. And other than that, peeps, I will see you. I am still going to do a NXT and a SmackDown video, so look forward to those. Other than that, I appreciate your support. Peace out, and I will catch you guys later. Thanks. Bye.
Oh! Wait a minute, stay out, ref. The queen can handle this. Oh!
Yes. By Flair.
And oh, no!
On the outside!
Tag team Tuffy and Kevin Owens.
King, it was 2-on-1.
Do not do it! Do not do it! Do not do it!